Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I know it's been a while for all of you guys who are subscribed. I haven't uploaded in probably a little bit over 2 years. I've been kind of focusing on my life. I will get into that a little bit more. But for those of you guys who aren't yet subscribed to the channel, I do want to say welcome. I hope you guys will stay around. Basically, what we're going to be doing on this channel is we're going to be turning this nice Nissan S13 right behind me. We are going to be documenting that whole journey and turning it into a drift car. So today we are going to be kind of getting everything started. As you can see, I got the car already up on jack stands and everything pretty much ready to go. What we're gonna be doing first is we're gonna actually be rebuilding the entire rear subframe of this car. So we're gonna take it out, redo all the bushings. I'm probably gonna put a suspension kit in there. Of course, weld the diffs. We can do cool slide stuff with the car. First things first, what we're gonna be doing today is I'm gonna blast the wheels off and I'm also gonna take the kit off, just kind of make my life easier. And that way I won't have nearly as much stuff in my way. So before we get started on the car, I do want to give you guys a little bit of an update. As you can see, this is a never before seen space. Not anything crazy as of right now, but I do finally have my own garage. So since I haven't uploaded in so long, I wanted to kind of explain to you guys. I moved from Northern Michigan. I now live in Indianapolis. And with that being said, I've been working, focusing on a new career, but now that I'm settled and everything, I finally have my own garage, which has always been like a lifelong goal of mine, even since I was like 16 years old when I had a Miata, which if you guys remember that car, you guys go way, way, way back. But I've always dreamed about having my own two-car garage, and we finally have one. As you can see, I got some DeBorees hanging up in the back. I do gotta finish my collection back there, make it look a little more personalized because it looks a little bland. It's kind of ugly right now, but we're gonna be getting into that. So what I want to do is give you guys a little bit of a tour of the space we're working with. Obviously we have the car on this side just kind of chilling by itself. I got as much room as possible. We're gonna start a little Nabori flag collection right there. If you come around on the other side of the car, obviously I gotta have my garbage because I got real life stuff that I need to take care of. This is gonna be all of my detailing supplies on this little table over here. So I'm gonna get a little cabinet and organize all that and make it really, really nice. All this right here, that's just a bunch of miscellaneous garbage that's on the floor. I'm gonna get a shelf so I can go ahead and organize everything over there. And then I pretty much have everything that I need as of right now in this little corner. I might get some stuff, put it above the toolbox and the workbench area, make it really nice. I'm gonna put a vise on there, all this stuff. So I do have some plans. It's looking a little empty and a little ugly right now, but just bear with me guys. It's definitely gonna look sick come in the future videos. And I'll probably be making some videos about transforming this and making it really, really nice. I did already upgrade the LED bulbs in the ceiling. I got these really big ones that kind of like fold out. I'm sorry if this kind of hurts your guys' eyes, but it's super, super bright. Definitely makes it really easy to work in here. It makes it a lot better, but we're gonna go ahead and get to work on the car. I'm gonna blast these wheels off first thing, and then we'll get started on the kit. So the wheels obviously are off. Here's where we're at. Car's up in the air, wheels are off. I just stuffed them over here in the corner. It is nice to know I still got plenty of tire tread left, so that's pretty cool. For anybody who doesn't know, these are 370Z anniversary wheels. Correct me if I'm wrong, or 350Z anniversary wheels. But I really like them. They're a little beat up, but I might get them restored at some point. But I got the homie hooking me up with a cooler set, which I'll keep a secret for now, but these definitely look good on stock body S chassis. Would recommend for all you S chassis guys out there. As you can see, you know, the car's pretty clean, but obviously the wheels have not been off in a very long time. Very crusty, pretty gross. For those of you guys that don't know, in the front, I believe the only mod I have is coilovers, and then obviously the brakes are not stock, but who cares about that anyway. So we got coilovers on the front. In the rear, same thing, not super, super, super bad. Obviously where the wheel was is a little bit crusty, but everything looks pretty good. I got tane or however you guys wanna say it, coilovers in the rear as well. And then I think this is an old ISR upper control arm. But anyway, those are really nice to have. It's adjustable for one. And secondly, it makes the coilover really, really easy to get out. So for the most part, pretty stock. Anyway, so the wheels are off. Now we're gonna get started on the kit. I'm thinking I'm gonna do the front bumper first. I don't think it'll be all that terrible. I did already take out the bolts from the top, so I'm all good there. And I
personally, I have a fastener in here, which is where the OEM bumper mounts. So I put a bolt up in there to hold that. And then of course, just into the fender, I have a couple of 10 mils holding this thing on. So that should be pretty easy. I'll get started on that and we will go from there. But once we take the front bumper off, I'm sure it'll be looking pretty naked. Side skirts are super easy. And then the rear bumper might throw me for a loop, but we'll see.
I'm just doing this for educational sake. When I first put this kit on, I got a lot of questions about how I mounted it and everything, because apparently when everybody else throws on KVD kits, they sag super, super bad, but I think it's user error if you ask me. I just use all of the factory mounting positions and it works just fine. So I'm gonna kind of show you what I mean by that.
If you come over here, so the factory bumper has this metal bracket that goes on top. Obviously the screws are gone. So you can actually connect this metal bracket straight to the KVD bumper. And that way you don't have any sag up here. The hood is nice and flush with it. Like I mentioned already, I have the bolt in there, which is where the factory bumper mounts, and then the two down here, which with me, I've had no problems. I've taken it on the highway multiple times, never had any problems with the bumper sagging or folding over. So it's pretty, pretty easy, but I'm gonna go ahead and do some YouTube magic and blast this thing off real quick. All right guys, so I got the front bumper off. As you can see, it's looking a little bit naked. It's kind of weird. I got my little fog lights dangling down there. Pretty janky, but it is off. As you can see, I got the factory crash bar in here. Everything's pretty exposed. Check out that nice crusty AC condenser. I'm thinking about restoring AC in this car. I don't really know, but we'll see. You know, I feel kind of lazy sometimes. Obviously, I got the bumper chilling over there. I do want to obviously paint it or wrap it. It's KVD, so bet you can't do that with fiberglass, huh? But it's kind of hard to paint for that reason, because it's flexible unless you put a flex agent in the paint. So that's why I'm kind of tossing around paint or wrap. If any of you guys have ever painted a car or anything, go ahead and leave a comment, give me some tips and tricks. But next we are going to do the side skirts. This is actually really, really simple. I don't really have a whole lot holding these on. These are all 10 mils, obviously. I got one right here in the wheel well, one on the fender right here, one in the rear quarter, which I'm gonna be replacing this one and the front one, I think, with riv nuts, because right now it's just like a janky self-tapper and I don't really wanna do that. So I'm gonna put a riv nut paint around it to avoid it rusting out in the future. And then I got two in the back holding it on. And then of course you gotta have one in your door, or two, sorry. So I got two in the door, two in the back, two on the sides. We're gonna blast those off. Get those off, it's pretty easy. So cue the time lapse.
All right guys, so here's where I'm at. We got the front bumpers off, the side skirts are off. Starting to look really naked and weird, but it's all good. So we got the front bumper off, I got the side skirts off, and we are gonna start on the rear bumper here in a second.
I am relieved to see that even underneath the side skirts and everything, it's not rusted out. Super, super clean all the way across. Usually they like to start to rust out here in the frame rails down in there. But in the front and the back, they're both very clean. Looks very good, so that's a relief. Like I said, these holes here, they will not be permanent. We are gonna put a riv nut in there to hold that on, paint over it, it'll be all good. As far as the rear bumper goes, this one might or might not be really, really aids to take off. I got two bolts kind of up in here, which is where it mounts factory, which those are the hard ones to get to. Some people don't put them in there, but I prefer my bumper not to fly off. I got two 10s right here in each side of the wheel well, so I gotta take those two out, super easy. These ones, eh. And then in the trunk, I'm missing all my carpeting and everything, but I do have the floor. If you remove that, there's two plugs right here, one and two. You pop those out and there's some big bolts right there that hold the factory crash bar in, because this does still have the factory crash bar in the bumper. So I'm gonna go ahead and blast this off. I'm probably gonna do another little YouTube magic trick, because it's getting a little late and I don't wanna be out here all night, but we're gonna go ahead and get that off real quick. All right guys, as you can see, I got the kit fully off the car. Looking a little weird. It's really, really plain Jane. I haven't seen it like this in a long, long time. I did get the rear bumper off, the two that go right here were by far the worst, but my girlfriend was nice enough to help me out and we were able to get that out. The worst ones, well, you got those for the actual bash bar. The two that sucked were tucked way back in that little corner right there, so not fun at all, but it is off. We'll have to take the blast pipes off. Don't forget when you're taking this off to undo your license plate lights. Otherwise, I'll probably rip that harness and that would not be fun. But I got the kit chilling over here on the floor. Everything's all good. As you can see with the KBD kit, it does use the factory crash support, which is really, really cool. These are those four big bolts that were in the trunk. A little rusty, so I'm thinking I might paint this and freshen it up because it kind of looks really aged and I don't really want that spreading to the rest of the car. But we do have the entire kit off the car. Everything is all good.
So with that being said, I have accomplished what I wanted to do today just to kind of help set me up for the rear subframe removal. So now everything is stripped down and it's a lot more simple, so there won't be nearly as much stuff in my ways. But since I'm done out here, I am going to head inside, take a shower because I'm a little dirty. And obviously I was sweating, putting in the work, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna go inside, take a shower, and I'm gonna meet you guys inside and show you a little something. So I'll see you in a bit. All right guys, what's up? Coming at you from a little bit of a different room. I'm just about to transfer all the vlog footage over so I can get it everything edited and everything. But I just wanted to make a quick outro while I'm chilling in here. And I'm gonna show you something for all you gamers out there. This is my PC setup. Got a little sim sitting over here. Triple monitors over there. Got the PC in the corner, nice and clean. I play a lot of Assetto on this and everything. I would like to kind of get into streaming that at some point, but obviously I don't have a huge following right now. But if you guys would be interested in watching like Assetto videos or anything like that, just comment and let me know, because I mean, sometimes it gets a little slow and Assetto is always fun to keep you in the habit and get a little bit of practice in with the bros, so that's always cool. But I just wanted to kind of say thank all you guys who are tuning in, and I'm really excited to get the build going and everything. For all of you people who are new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can kind of stay connected with us and follow along. But tomorrow, or the next video that you guys will be seeing, I'm gonna get to work on the actual rear subframe removal. So we'll see how that goes. I'm not exactly super excited, but I think we'll be all right. It's not too rusty. I'm thinking my plan of attack is gonna be to drop the entire thing at once. So we will see how that goes. But I'm gonna go ahead and get all of the footage plopped into my laptop right here so I can get editing it. And I guess I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.